This message is for the Christians of this world. Whoever you are, wherever you are, whatever style of Christianity you practice, even if you are the most exotic and well-kept secret in the entire field, you are not unknown to me, for I am your king. I am your prophet, I am your priest, I am your brother, and it is by my blood this whole world is saved. I've come here to tell you today, especially those of you who can speak this English language and are residing here in the United States of America, those of you who are white men, you living in Northern Europe, all of you who are the controllers of the world, those of you who go and you preach with your prayers and your fancy mega churches in your suits and your ties. I have come here wearing rags, using the pantheons and teachings of the world outside of you, to come and show you and tell you the way, and to guarantee you this. If you hate Muslims, if you look down on pagans, if you look out at the world and think the Buddhists are lost, if you think that the Hindus are all going to hell, and if you are treating my LGBTQ brothers and sisters with hatred and intolerance, if you have looked out on any person in this world and you have seen fit to deny them or to treat them ill or to do to them as you would not want to have done unto you, I want you to know, those of you who have worn that cross, you have taken that sacred sacrament, you have had that Eucharistic experience, those of you who have prayed in that name, and those of you who have come to my altars and you have asked me for things that you are not even deserving of in the first place, all of you who have locked other people in cages and gone out and destroyed other people's lands and their families and their lives, you have thought that this is all okay and you have sought to call yourself Christian warriors, I am here to doubt today to tell you, there is no Christian warrior. There are no conservative Christians. There is not one Christian in this world who believes in capitalism. There is not one Christian in this world who follows the teachings of Paul, Peter, James, John. There is not one. There are only those that will know the experience and the words and the teachings of Yeshua ben Yosef, the Son of Man, who has come to tell you, put all your fishes and your loaves in one basket and split them up among yourselves. Give unto Caesar that which is Caesar's and don't give him no more. I have told you all these things. I have told you to have nothing. I have told you to take less. I have told you to give up everything that you have and go out and spread yourself upon suffering so that it cannot live anymore. For this, you will kill me again? What will you do now that you have seen this and you are knowing that this thing has come back to the form of a man here on this earth? What will you do here in America, you Christian people who do not even believe in the evolution of your own experience? How do you think Christianity got from where it started to Mitt Romney? Huh? There's no evolution? It did not take a path? It did not have a mini branch along the way? Let me tell you something about the oak trees in winter of Sonoma County, huh? Let me tell you something about the neural system of your body. Let me tell you something about what you see when you peer into space. I know the path of evolution. I know the heartbeat of this world. I am the one who has come to tell you all what you are supposed to be doing, and now you are going to even listen to me. Let's see. Take your churches, all of you, every single one, from the Pope to Salt Lake City, Thomas S. Monson, every single one of you, every single one of you who call yourself a Christian minister, take your buildings and your churches and turn them into brothels and bars and pool houses. Make them places that people want to come. Feed them on your own budget. Let them choose how it looks. Let them choose what to believe. Let them tell you of their experience of the one who's tattooed upon their backs. Let them show you how to run your church. Open your places up. Stop fucking singing stupid music and praying silly stupid things. Why don't you watch football on Sunday morning instead? You will have everyone there. Put up free food. Put up free clothes. Put up people who do not have shelter inside at night. That is what I command of you. Make it free, make it voluntary, and make it 24/7, 7-Eleven. Better than Walmart, better than anything. Home-cooked food, brand new friends, place to play volleyball, place to get a rest, place to have a read, place to get educated. Make all of them open and free and formless and nothing other than the truth and the way. Stop arguing about stupid things and stop reading the same stupid book over and over and over and over and over again. Expand your horizons and go out and find what this world is really all about. Talk to each other, visit each other, go everywhere, meet each other on your own terms, and then hammer out what is the difference so that you can find the way between. For that is what will make you strong. That is what will tie your unbreakable knot. And that is what will save this world. I can't do it alone. If you help me, we will put this atheist to shame. Huh? And then we'll be running back begging for a spot at the feet, huh? But if you don't help me, this whole world is going to shit. And that is very evident. There is only one way to save this without absolute total bloodshed and fucking annihilation of the entire human species. And that is going to be arranged, believe it. If you want to save this world, you had better open up your doors. And you had better make it free. And you had better make it cool. And you had better make it something people want to come and do. Because if you cannot do that, and have a good time, and make it fun, and stop talking about all these stupid things that don't matter, you are not going to succeed. And this world is going down the drain, and this whole place is going to be in the crap. Obama cannot save you. There is no solution that is economic. The economy is what is killing this whole planet. You've got to make it free, you've got to make it fun, and you've got to make it for everyone. You have to make it open. You have to make it none and all. Join me. I'm the institution of none and all, and I've come here to show you the way. I have come here to show you how we will save this whole planet. We will do it by tomorrow, next afternoon, in the week of this time, no, next week. You want to know what? Do it now. We can't do it now. Open up these churches. Make them fun. Put a pool table inside and take out your stupid hymnals. Put in a DJ. Make a dance floor. Be there on Saturday night, barbecue on Sunday morning, watching football. Give other people a chance to meditate in the back if they want to. And if they want to sing and sing songs, let them. Let the people do what they want. Let them tell you how to run it. You put up the organization and the money. If you are a minister, if you are anywhere in any charge of anything that is in the name of that holy, holy being. If you have a cross on your lawn, if you have anything of insignia that is making you something that is tied to my crucifixion and atonement, I'm going to tell you something right now. You had better be doing this by Friday next week. Because if you are not, I am going to show this world how nasty this can get. I am going to bring down the holy sacred flames of fucking Jupiter, and they are going to torch all of the fucking planet into such a terrible searing. Oh, we don't want to do that. Come on. Art, music, fun, good times, make tea. I don't care if you drink. You can have a fucking orgy if you want. Just open it up. Make all of them 24/7, 365. You can go there and get anything you want for free. Fuck the market, come to the church. Separate the church and the state, and the church take off and go where it's never been before. Put it the way I wanted it in the first place. Make it an open place, a free place, a place where the people don't have to listen to your fucking bullshit. Don't have to be yelled at all the time, huh? Make it done. Do it now, and this world will be free. I'm telling you, that's a solution you can't fuck with. It's anthropological, baby. Scientific. I figure it out. You will see. Come back to me.